Assalamu alaikum, dear students. So this is the lecture which is in connection with the previous lecture. And this is lecture number 21. Lecture number 20, I started teaching you how to use dictionaries effectively. Remember how to teach dictionaries effectively. And here I am now teaching you further. And this is the connection with the previous one. There are some more important points which you must know so that you can use dictionaries. First, you can select good dictionaries and you can then use them in an effective way. So I told you, as if you remember, that words have more than one meaning, and I have given you many examples of that as well. For example, there is a word, simple word, sit. Sit has many meanings. First meaning that we generally know is sit on chair or in a chair or anywhere where we sit. You can see its grammar status, and you can also see which word adverb and which prepositions are used with this particular word. And then you can see whether it is transitive and or intransitive. Second meaning of sit, you can see to put somebody in a sitting position. Bithana jisam ke apne, to put somebody in a sitting position. This is also called sit. He lifted the child and set her on the wall. Set her here means usne bacche ko uthaya aur diwar par bitha diya. To yahan pe aapne yahan sit ke meaning bithana bhi hai. Yani ke isse pehli meaning to humne dekha sit intransitive tha. Here sit is intransitive. It means that it cannot be used for others. It can be used only for subject. But in the second meaning, sit can also be used for others. यानी कि आप ये एक action किसी और के साथ भी perform कर सकते हैं. तो ये एक अच्छी dictionary आपको बताएगी कि whether it is transitive or intransitive. और transitive है तो फिर किस तरह इसका use करना होगा. और if it is intransitive, then how to use it. She set him down in front of the fire with a hot drink. So she set him down, usne bitha diya niche in front of the fire, aag ke samne, with a hot drink. Aur kuch hot drink bhi peene ke liye di, jaise kahwa ho gaya, chai ho gayi. Fir uske baad aage dekhiyega, there are many other meanings. Maine meaning number 3rd, 4th, 5th ko I think skip kar diya. And then meaning number 6, you can see here, transitive, intransitive, rather formal. आगे ब्रैकेट में आपको बताया जा रहा है, इट इज शोइंग इट्स रजिस्टर दैट इट इज मोर फॉर्मल टू डू इन एग्जाम्स. ब्रिटिश, इट मींस इट इज यूज्ड इन ब्रिटिश इंग्लिश. समथिंग कैंडिडेट्स, अब आपके पास क्या है, कैंडिडेट्स विल सिट. लेट मी शो यू दिस एग्जाम्पल्स. कैंडिडेट्स विल सिट इन द एग्जाम्स इन जून. इट मींस दैट दे विल डू देयर एग्जाम्स इन जून. तो यहाँ पे सिट की एक और मीनिंग हमें पता चल गई. Most of the candidates sit at least 5 GCSEs, especially American, North American, for something. He was about to sit for his entrance exams. So, इसी को अगर हम यहाँ देखें, if we see the same thing in the real, dictionary. So, here we go. Here we can see the example of sit. You can see here now live example of this word sit. The first meaning, then grammar point of sit. It is telling us about some grammar aspect of grammar. Just plus ko dabaya to usme aapko bataya jayega sit kaun इन और एट के साथ कैसे इस्तेमाल करते हैं. देन यू कैन सी वेयर वी यूज एट. देन सिनोनिम ऑफ सिट, दीज आर द सिनोनिम्स. एंड देन एक्स्ट्रा एग्जांपल्स ऑफ सिट. एंड ऑक्सफोर्ड कॉलोकेशन डिक्शनरी विल टेल यू अबाउट कॉलोकेशन. दीज आर द डिटेल्स व्हिच आर डिक्शनरी टेल यू इज टेलिंग यू. एंड देन सेकेंड मीनिंग व्हिच आई हैव ऑलरेडी शोन यू. थर्ड मीनिंग ऑफ सिट इज दिस वन. फोर्थ मीनिंग ऑफ सिट, फिफ्थ मीनिंग ऑफ सिट, पार्लियामेंट सिट्स फॉर लेस देन 6 मंथ्स ऑफ द ईयर. So here sit has different meaning. Then exams, number seven meaning of bird, to rest on a branch etc., or to stay on a nest to keep the eggs warm. जैसे मुर्गी के लिए इस्तेमाल की जा सकती है कि जब मुर्गी अंडे पर बैठती है तो दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड सिट एंड हियर इट इज इन नंबर 8 मीनिंग. सो यू कैन सी एक सिंपल सा वर्ड है हमारे पास सिट, उसके कितने सारे मीनिंग्स और फिर उनका ग्रामर स्टेटस आपके सामने आ रहा है. इससे बढ़ के और क्या होगा, वी आर लर्निंग, वी आर गेनिंग नॉलेज ऑफ ऑल सच थिंग. अब इससे क्या होगा, इट विल इम्प्रूव, इट विल इंक्रीज आर वोकैबुलरी एंड इट विल इंक्रीज आर यू नो यू कैन से इट विल इम्प्रूव आर यूजेज एज वेल. देखें 8वीं मीनिंग, टू सिट ऑन इट्स बॉटम विद इट्स फ्रंट लेग्स स्ट्रेट. टेक केयर ऑफ चिल्ड्रन, इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड सिट, राइट. एंड देन देर आर सम मीडियम्स ऑफ सिट, देर आर सम मैनी फ्रेजल वर्ब्स विच आर रिलेटेड टू सिट. So you, this is how you can, you know, go for the meanings. Dictionaries tell us that the same verb is transitive and intransitive both with examples. Sometimes it also happens that one verb has both the qualities. It is transitive as well as intransitive. So a dictionary will tell you about this. इसकी example मैं आपको काफी दिखा चुका हूँ, right? ये देखें, इसकी let me give you some more example. Our dictionary will tell you the same verb. Yeah, this is, you can see here. Can you see this one? Transitive, intransitive, and then further more examples of about register. So ye transitive hai ya intransitive hai, our good dictionary will also tell you about this. It is intransitive only. Is meaning mein ye dono hai, transitive bhi intransitive bhi. Means it can be used for subject and it can also be used for object. Similarly, these are the meanings of this particular word verb. You can see verb has many meanings, and you know, sometimes it is transitive, sometimes it is intransitive, right? If you don't know about transitive and intransitive, remember you will face problem in making the passive. Passive voice is something that we can only make when we know properly about transitive and intransitive verb. Many students make mistake when they make passive voice. Why? Because they have little knowledge of transitive and intransitive verb, or they have they don't know properly things related to grammar. Most dictionaries belong to more than one word classes. Most verbs belong to more than one word classes. There are 8 to 9 word classes. We all know part speech like noun, pronoun, adverb, adjective. So there are many words which belong to more than one word classes. Like this word shit, it is an exclamation, it is a noun, it is a verb and adjective. So it has 4 word classes. How many word classes are there? Can anyone tell me what word classes are? यस, पता चला मैं बोल रहा हूँ और आप लोगों को इस चीज़ का पता ही नहीं. वर्ड क्लासेस के बारे में किसी को आइडिया, कोई इस बारे में बताएगा मुझे? यस, कैन एनीवन हियर मी? ऐसा लगता है कि आप लोगों ने ज्वाइन तो किया लेकिन कोई क्लास.
यस सर, आवाज आ रही है सर आपकी.
सर मैं खामोशी करवा दी यार, थोड़ा सा क्लास लेने के दौरान तो कम से कम खामोशी से पार्टिसिपेशन भी तो होनी चाहिए भाई. पार्टिसिपेट करेंगे तो आप लोगों को पता चलेगा ना टीचर को कि आप लोग कितने कैपेबल हैं. हम मार्क्स कैसे देंगे जब हमें पता ही नहीं होगा स्टूडेंट्स के बारे में यार, क्लास ले रहे हैं कोई बात ही नहीं कर रहा, कोई बोल ही नहीं रहा, कोई पार्टिसिपेट ही नहीं कर रहा, तो कैसे कैसे मतलब ये असेसमेंट होगी. तो आप पार्टिसिपेट करें, पता चले आप लोगों के बारे में कि कौन कितना मेहनती है और कितना मतलब मेहनत कर रहा है, एफर्ट्स कर रहा है. हाँ, वेदर इट इज़ ऑनलाइन क्लास और फिजिकल क्लासेस, पार्टिसिपेशन इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. मैंने अभी आप लोगों से सवाल पूछा कि वर्ड क्लास के हवाले से, तो कैन यू टेल मी अबाउट दिस?
सर नो आइडिया.
वर्ड क्लास पढ़ा नहीं कभी आप लोगों ने? कंपल्सरी इंग्लिश में तो पढ़ी होगी ना आप लोगों ने फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर में?
सर
what classes what class actually what class means part speech ye to padha hi hoga aap logon ne
what yes sir
past parts of speech and in modern day it is called word class so there are 8 to 9 word classes means there are 8 to 9 part speeches and a good dictionary will tell you about these all parts of speeches right like exclamation like noun verb adjective jis tarah se is word ka ye aapke paas different classes hai below you can see you know its register it is about its usage with for example this word is a taboo it is slang so it is showing us that we should avoid using this word why because it is considered bad it is considered slang or taboo jisko hum urdu mein kehte hain behuda word jisko hum kehte hain na a swear word then come down you can see it is as a noun first it is exclamation then it is as a noun then you can see it is used you know it is whether countable or uncountable ye bhi bata raha hai phir iske baad mazid you can see it is used as a verb it mean what does it mean ye bhi aapko bata raha hai and then you can see whether it is transitive or intransitive wo bhi aapko show kar raha hai theek hai so this is actually quality of a good dictionary adjective ke taur pe isko kaise istemal kiya jana chahiye so you can see over here there are a shit team it is the example sometimes the dictionary does not give ample examples it also happens that sometimes we don't get enough examples kabhi kabhi aisa bhi hota hai ki zyada misale hame nahi milti for example there is a word delicious so pronunciation you can see in front of you and it's you know adjective which means that loses its leaves every year compare evergreen now they have not given any example of sentence example nahi diye to jisse kabhi kabhi hame problem hoti hai तो इस प्रॉब्लम से बचने के लिए हमारे पास एक रास्ता ये भी कि हम दूसरी डिक्शनरी को यानी कि एक पे डिपेंड ना करें वी शुड नॉट डिपेंड ऑन वन डिक्शनरी एक में अगर कुछ नहीं मिला तो हम दूसरी डिक्शनरी पर जाएं दूसरे में भी नहीं मिला तो हम तीसरी को देख लें दिस इज हाउ वी कैन गेट और वी कैन सर्च वर्ड्स सो आई हैव शोन यू थ्री डिक्शनरीज ऑक्सफर्ड एडवांस लर्नर लॉन्गमैन्स डिक्शनरी एंड आई हैव ऑल्सो शोन यू वन मोर डिक्शनरी दैट इज कॉलिंस डिक्शनरी दीज आर थ्री ऑथेंटिक डिक्शनरीज इसके अलावा और भी डिक्शनरीज हमारे पास हैं बट दीज आर थ्री ऑथेंटिक एंड गुड डिक्शनरीज उम्मीद करता हूं कि इनमें आपको इंशाल्लाह चीज मिल जाएगी एनी क्वेश्चन रिगार्डिंग दिस
सर नो क्वेश्चन
नो सर
Okay, now I'm giving you some time. Means I'm giving you 2 or 3 minutes, and there's a slide in front of you. Just try to understand what this slide, you know, has. You have 2 to 3 minutes. Yes. This is a learner's dictionary. It contains idiom phrasal verbs related to word. So you can see there is a word fair. There is a word fair, which is adjective, adverb, and noun all, which has all these qualities. You can see here there's an idiom, all is fair in love and war. And it is also proverb saying, this is also a part vocabulary. Then you can see be fair. It is informal. And it is also a phrase. Be fair means or foul. And a fair crack of the whip. It is British informal. So you can see here that idioms and phrasal verbs and sayings and proverbs, they all you can get from a good dictionary. If you buy bilingual dictionary means English to Urdu or Urdu to English, yani ke do zamano ki dictionary hoti hai. So you will not be able to find, you know, such variety of meanings. But if you buy monolingual dictionary, means one language dictionary, for example, English to English or Urdu to Urdu, then you'll get these multiple or many varieties of, you know, things which are related to meaning. Then you can see further idioms, informal, British English, and all such. Dictionaries which can be used for study purpose. Dictionary which can be used for study purpose. Now, these are the names of some dictionaries which I recommend you to use online. इसमें अगर आपको किसी ने किसी को कुछ सवाल पूछा तो मुझसे पूछ सकते हैं. ऑक्सफोर्ड एडवांस
सर, ये सर ये पाइन डिक्शनरी है ना, ये कौन सी है डिक्शनरी?
दिस इज अ डिक्शनरी, वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग डिक्शनरी. इस डिक्शनरी की खास बात मैं आपको ये बताऊं कि इट विल गिव यू एग्जांपल्स फ्रॉम लिटरेचर एज वेल, द वर्ल्ड ऑफ लिटरेचर एज वेल. फॉर एग्जांपल यू कैन सी आई एम शोइंग यू राइट नाउ पाइन डिक्शनरी. लेट मी शो यू. Fine dictionary, here we go. Can you see things in front of you?
Yes, sir.
Just wait. Yeah. Now, for example, I need a word move. I've typed here. You can see here now. These are the words I've just typed here. And you can see now examples are being shown from literature. देखिए सारी इसकी मिसालें दी जा रही हैं विद मीनिंग्स. सेंचुरी डिक्शनरी एंड एनसाइक्लोपीडिया, इडियम्स, कोटेशंस फ्रॉम सच इन विच मूव इज यूज्ड, टर्मिनोलॉजी यूजेज इन लिटरेचर. कैन यू सी ऑल दिस? नजर आ रहा है आप लोगों को? Can you see this, what I'm showing you? Usage in literature,
move, yes,
in poetry. So yeah, actually this dictionary is so useful from this perspective. The news mein jo istemal ho raha hai move, you can see here. In science and technology. And then it will show you synonyms. It will show you hyponyms, right? Ye sara iska hai. To ye ek detail mein aapko cheeze batayegi, reverse dictionary. So it's very interesting for literature students, for you who study, who are studying literature. कोई भी वर्ड यू नो एनी वर्ड यू कैन फाइंड एंड इट विल शो यू ऑल सच एटिमोलॉजी एंड कोटेशंस एंड ऑल सच. टेक होम ले लेते हैं इस तरह से, देखिए सारा टेक से रिलेटेड फ्रेजल वर्ब एंड ऑल सच थिंग. किसी जिसको आप वट एवर यू वॉन्ट यू कैन जस्ट टेक ऑफ कॉम ले लेते हैं. ये टेक ऑफ का मीनिंग्स ऑफ टेक ऑफ विद एग्जाम्पल्स राइट, quotations from renowned people, idioms, usage, poetry, and in news, literature, science. Is this clear?
Sir.
So these are all the examples of monolingual dictionaries. Oxford Advanced Learner, Longman Advanced Dictionary of Contemporary English, Cambridge Advanced Learner's Dictionary, Collins Dictionary, Fine Dictionary, Oxford Collocations Dictionary, and all online dictionaries. There are some other dictionaries which are online. These dictionaries are also available offline, means you can buy these dictionaries from any you know big bookshop, from Oxford or UP, from Oxford you can publishers you can buy you know many of these dictionaries. Bilingual dictionary. Bilingual dictionary means a dictionary which contains two languages, target language and source language, like Urdu to English or English to Urdu. So these are also available, and of course online dictionaries are also available. So if you have any question regarding this, you can ask me please. अगर किसी को इस हवाले से कुछ पूछना हो तो मुझसे पूछ सकते हैं. नो क्वेश्चन इज कमिंग. जस्ट gentlemen, if you have any question regarding dictionaries, use of dictionaries, and how to use dictionary effectively, and which dictionary should be used, what dictionary suits you know students at what level, so if you have any question regarding this you can ask me. No question. It means that you have understood, or या तो आपको समझ आ गया होगा तो या नहीं आया होगा. सवाल पूछना तो जरूरी चीज होती है. Anyhow, tonight, inshallah, at 10 o'clock, I will start your presentation. I will have one session tonight, right? So some students have sent me their presentation, and I expect some more students to send their presentation, and then I'll tell you tonight के अगली presentation session मैं कब लूँगा. लेकिन जल्दी लूँगा, maybe tomorrow, or maybe day after tomorrow, because we don't have much time. So I hope some students will give their presentation tomorrow, and they will leave a very good impression on their teacher. Okay. So with this, I conclude. I end this session. Thank you very much.